Welcome to In 5 Minutes. The agenda of this clip is to understand the dynamic characteristics of a CMOS inverter. Let's get started. In the previous clip, we have studied the static characteristics of a CMOS inverter, in which we found out the static power dissipation, noise margin, and other parameters. Here, we are going to consider the dynamic characteristics or the switching characteristics. And when I talk about dynamic characteristics, I'm going to draw a capacitor at my output for the simple reason that in static characteristics, we saw that the reason why capacitor was not drawn was because we assumed the output to have a steady state voltage. So when I have a steady state voltage at the output, there is no difference in the voltage, so dV is equal to zero. And if I have to presume a current IC flowing across a capacitor output node, IC is given by C dV by dt. In this case, it's CL. But because it was steady state or static characteristics, dV was zero, so IC was zero. And that's the reason we had not drawn the capacitor at the output when we studied static characteristics. However, when we study dynamic characteristics or the switching characteristics, we need to identify the speed of our device or the delay of our circuit, which is given by tau equal to R into C. C is nothing but CL. This load capacitance comprises of the gate capacitance of the next stage and the other capacitance of the current device, which we have already studied the capacitances oxide based and junction based in the previous clips. So this is CL, this is the value of tau. Currently, what we are concerned with is to identify the definition of some of the basic terms like propagation delay and rise and fall time. So let's first see propagation delay's definition. Suppose my inverter had an input 1 and it produces an output 0, but inverter took approximately 2 nanoseconds to produce this output, then this is nothing but the propagation delay of this inverter. So in simple words, propagation delay is nothing but time taken for a circuit or the logic to produce the output when the input is given. This is a very basic or the layman's definition. Now, there are two types of propagation delay. One is a high to low propagation delay. Another one is a low to high propagation delay. Now, we need to understand both of this. High to low and low to high are the terms given with respect to the output. So let's quickly see what does this definition mean. So here, suppose I have drawn my input. This is my input, correct? And this is my time t. And here suppose I'm drawing my output V out, and this is my time t again. Let's presume that my input was initially zero, but slowly it went high and then it again came back to zero. At the same time, let's see what is the corresponding output. When my input was zero, my output was high. If you mark it properly, here is a time where your input goes high and here is a time when your input goes low. But as we saw that when the input becomes high, I don't get my output instantaneously. I get after some delay, which is nothing but 2 nanoseconds in this example. So I would understand that the output will go low after some time interval, and it will also go high after some time interval. So this is output high to low. So this is propagation delay high to low. And this output low to high. So this is propagation delay low to high. Now let's understand how do we find and or what is the exact definition. So the exact definition is nothing but the following. Let's say this is the 50% when the input has gone from low to high or high to low, and this is the 50% when the output has gone from high to low or low to high. So propagation delay is nothing but, see if it makes sense, the delay between this point and this point. This is propagation delay high to low. We'll define it soon, just wait on. And the delay between this point and this point, it's nothing but propagation delay low to high. Now let's understand this definition. So propagation delay high to low is a time delay. Very simple. Is a time delay, correct? This is a time delay. Is a time delay between the V 50% transition of the rising input voltage. So the input voltage is rising 50% of the rising. So it's nothing but the time delay between the V 50% transition of the rising input voltage and, what can you say, and the V 50% transition, this is the 50% of the falling output voltage. So basically, when input voltage is rising by 50% and when the output voltage is falling by 50%, This point to this point is nothing but my propagation delay high to low. Similarly, we can define propagation delay low to high. It is the time delay when my input voltage transits from high to low, 50% of that, to my output voltage rising from low to high, 50% of that. And the time difference or the time delay for this to happen is nothing but my propagation delay low to high. So this is what exactly is propagation delay low to high and high to low. Hope you have followed. Stay tuned.